In this video, you'll learn how to say that you find something easy or hard in German. I'll present two different methods to express these ideas in either a simple or a complex way, and also explain the grammar behind the structure so that you can apply them in any context. This is method number one. You can use any of the following three phrases: es leicht finden, es schwer finden, or as schwierig finden, followed by a comma, and then the phrase etwas zu tun, in order to express how easy or hard you find something. Let's look at these different parts in order. Firstly, the words leicht, schwer, and schwierig. Leicht is the word for light, as in light as a feather in German. Schwer, on the other hand, is the opposite. It means heavy, literally. But metaphorically, these are the two words that German uses to express whether something is easy or hard. Schwierig, on the other hand, is simply the word for difficult, so it's a synonym for schwer. When you use one of these phrases, you're going to use the infinitive finden and use it in its conjugated form. That is, you're going to put an ending on it depending on who's finding something easy or hard. Now let's look at the second part. Etwas simply means something. Zu, you should know by now, means to. And this word tun can seem a little perplexing. Tun is actually a verb. It's got nothing to do with the German word tun, as in tunfisch, which is the word for tuna, but pronounced exactly the same. But rather, it's a synonym for machen. It just means to do. And even though it doesn't have an en at the end of it, it's not too irregular. If you look at the conjugation in the bottom right of the screen, you'll see that the en is chopped off, and it's actually quite normal, except that where you would expect an en, there is simply an n. But in the past tense, there is an irregular past participle, and that is getan. Ich habe getan. But this second part of the first method, etwas zu tun, we don't want to actually change, because this is what we might call a zu clause. That is, you have an infinitive form of the verb which is unchanged, and in front of it, the word zu. This is a very common structure after verbs which are not modal verbs. In order to apply this, let's look at some example sentences. Firstly, ich finde es leicht, Italienisch zu lernen. Notice that the first half of the sentence includes the verb finden, but in its conjugated form. It's matched with the correct ending according to ich, who's in charge of the verb. But the second half of the sentence is a zu clause containing an unconjugated infinitive, lernen, preceded by the word zu. Next, mein Bruder findet es leicht, sich zu verlaufen. My brother finds it easy to get lost. Again, finden is conjugated according to the person in charge of the verb, which is a he, mein Bruder, and the second half of the sentence is a zu clause, with the unconjugated infinitive verlaufen preceded by zu. Notice that this is in fact a reflexive verb which needs the word sich, himself, but everything except the zu is pushed to the start of the zu clause in order to make room for the zu and the infinitive at the end. Thirdly, meine Frau findet es schwierig, bei warmem Wetter zu schlafen. My wife finds it difficult to sleep in hot weather. Again, finden has been conjugated to the Z form this time because meine Frau is feminine, third person singular, and the zu clause remains in its unchangeable state with an unconjugated infinitive schlafen preceded by zu and all the other information provided before those two final words. Fourthly, für Ausländer ist es schwer, den bayerischen Dialekt zu verstehen. For foreigners, it's hard to understand the Bavarian dialect. This time I've used a different verb, namely sein, but I've conjugated it with the same person, third person singular, because it's coupled with es, and we still have a zu clause in the second half, which is unchanged. We might call it infinitival. It has its unconjugated infinitive verstehen, preceded by zu, preceded by all the other information, in this case, the direct object, den bayerischen Dialekt. Finally, I do want to point out that you can use this method to say very simple and very useful sentences. For example, ich finde Geschichte leicht. I find history easy. You can slot in any noun, singular or plural, in that position rather than including a zu clause to express a more complex idea. But now you know both. Now let's look at method number two. Es fällt jemandem schwer, or es fällt jemandem leicht, etwas zu tun. Once again, we're finishing with an unchangeable zu clause. But we're using a different verb in the conjugated clause with this method. We're using the verb fallen. Why does it have an umlaut if the infinitive is fallen? Well, you might remember that this is in fact an irregular verb. It's du and er, sie, es forms, which are really the only two forms to ever change in the present tense. Change, which indicates that it is a strong verb in the past tense, that is, it maintains its en, and you would say, ich bin gefallen. You might have also noticed that the German word for someone, jemand, has a weird em ending in this phrase. That's because it is, in fact, dative. You are saying it falls easy or hard to someone to do something. Let's look at some examples then. Es fällt mir leicht, schnell zu reagieren. It's easy for me, or it comes easy to me, to react quickly. Notice that mir is in the dative case, and we've maintained everything else exactly as the model. Es fällt remains es fällt, because the subject's not going to change with this construction, and the unchangeable zu clause at the end, of course, will not be conjugated. Next example. Es fällt dir schwer, nein zu sagen. It's hard for you, or it comes hard to you, to say no. The only thing that needs to change in the first clause with the conjugated verb is the pronoun dir, because we're talking about the person we're talking to, and the infinitival zu clause at the end, of course, does not change. And finally, once again, I want to show you that this can be used in very simple and common sentences like das fällt mir schwer. So instead of using es, anticipating a zu clause after the main clause, we're using das as a pronoun to refer to something we've already spoken about or we're aware of. Finally, I want to provide you with some useful idiomatic expressions in order to express how easy something comes to you in German. You know how in English we have lots of these. For example, that's child's play, that's a piece of cake, easy peasy, that's a cinch, that's a breeze, that's a walk in the park. There are a few German expressions which are commonly used to express this notion. Das ist kinderleicht, das ist ein Kinderspiel, or simply, das ist einfach. And einfach is the German word for simple or simply and can be used as a synonym for leicht.